हेलो सुद्रा, गुड मॉर्निंग। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू लेसन दैट इज इन्फेक्शियस डिसीजेस एंड हाउ टू प्रिवेंट देम। इन द टाइटल इटसेल्फ सेड दैट द डिसीजेस आर इन्फेक्शियस। व्हाट इज मीन बाय इन्फेक्शियस? Infectious means the disease which spread in the community in rapid manner. So the pattern to prevent these diseases also differ from the other diseases. Okay. So let us start this lesson. Mother's burn or grandpa's baggage are not passed from them to other. However, one has to take care and stay away from the people who are ill with flu, cold, ringworm, scabies, chickenpox, etc. Why we must keep safe distance from the affected person? Because these diseases spread from one person to other very rapid. Such diseases are called as infectious disease. So one must keep safe distance from the infected person. These diseases are caused by microorganisms. Every infectious disease is caused by a specific microorganism or germs or bacteria. When a germs of a particular disease enter the body and begins to grow, the person gets the diseases. Okay. Very regularly we saw that a small child has a stomach problem due to some ringworms grow in the stomach of that child. So that person, that child becomes ill, okay? But this disease is not spread or infectious disease, okay? And the other disease, that is, if that child gets flu and through his sneezing, the bacteria of cold or a flu are spread around that child. If we come into the contact with that child, we also get affected from that diseases. Such are the sneezing. Sneezing is the general infectious disease. If someone sneezes, the bacteria spread into the air, and if some other person sitting near that child, he also got affected from that bacteria. Okay. there are also spread the germs of typhoid from person to person. Okay, how these infectious diseases spread? There are some ways through which this disease spread. The first is spread through the air. Okay, the germs like influenza are present in the spite or saliva of a person who has disease. When a cough or a spite, they enters the air with the droplets of saliva or a spite, when other people breathe in that same air, the germs enter in their bodies. Diseases of the throat and the chest spread through air. For example, a cold and cough, tuberculosis, that is TB, swine flu, etc. Okay, this is why we are told to cover our nose and mouth when we cough or sneeze. Okay, here is a picture of that girl. Behind that person, that person's spite or cough, and he throw out his saliva into the air, and that girl come into the contact with that air in the same air. So the diseases, if that person get diseases of TB, cough and swine flu, that the bacteria of that disease enters into the body of that girl. Okay, so we must keep a safe distance from such ill persons. So to protect, we must cover our mouth or face with our handkerchief or mask. Okay, and spend a very little time with that person. This is, if we take care of these, we can save ourselves from these infectious diseases. Okay, on the next page we have a very beautiful picture, that it is a picture of a village, stream or a river. In this picture we saw that the women's washing their clothes on the bank of that pond or a river. The person who fetch a water, same water for a drink, the children's play into the water with the animals, buffaloes and the other person under the trees. That child comes for a toilet under that tree on the near that pond. Okay, so everything is happened here. There are some others way also through which this water contaminated or become
polluted. Okay, if that person fetch this water for drink, we also get affected from that polluted water. So there are some diseases which spread through polluted water. Okay, the germs of the diseases of the intestine like typhoid, cholera, diarrhea are also of a jaundice are present in the faces of affected person. Faces of affected person. Okay, these germs enters into the water and it spread through the water. If another person drinks that water, we has been contaminated by these germs. They enter his intestine too, and that person can get the disease. To prevent the spread of disease in this manner, it is best to avoid washing clothes and bathing in the water source or defecating on the bank of water. So we must keep the water resource clean and unpolluted. We must take care of it. Another point is the spread of disease through food. In this picture, we saw one hotel where the foodstuffs are kept on the table openly. So the flies sit on that foodstuff and they also affect that foodstuff. So that foods also become polluted due to the flies and uncleanliness of that water hotel. We saw there is a tab on the wall which is unclean. They keep utensils in open space before washing. The person who carries food or do job as a waiter is also unclean, wearing unclean clothes. He also not keep himself very clean. So if we have food in such hotels or a restaurant or on the street vendors, we also get diseases through polluted foods. So we can get gastro or diarrhea by eating that contaminated food. These diseases spread through food. This is called food poisoning. We also see that there are some social events happened in our community. In that event, we saw that the foods are cooked openly in a unhygienic at a unhygienic place by the persons who are not keep himself very much clean, and the place is also not very much clean. In this picture we saw there is a home functions, community functions, that persons are sitting in a row for eating. The person giving foods to each everyone, the utensils keep at unclean places near the animals. So the flies sit on the gobers, are also sit on the foods, so that unhygienic foods are given to that people who are sitting for eating. The other animals also come to the eating places. They are unclean. Such a dog comes to the near that person's, behind that person's row. They also have carried some unhygienic flies and diseases. It also spread uncovered food. Due to this, we also get disease. Here are keeping food covered ensures that flies cannot sit on it. Dust and other rubbish in the surrounding also cannot enter it. This prevents the microorganisms from entering the food, and spread of diseases also prevented. Okay. The other way of spreading of diseases is through insect. We may be aware that one can get malaria from the bite of a certain kinds of mosquito. When these types of mosquito bites someone who has malaria, the malaria germs in that person's blood enter into mosquito's body. With blood it stuck. If this mosquito bite another person, the malaria germs enter that person's body too, and he too can get malaria. Insect like mosquito, lice, flies, spread, fleas, spread diseases. That is why we must stop such insects from breeding. So, to stop breeding of mosquitoes, we must keep our surroundings dry. We should not let the water, clean water, into the utensils, into the tire. So we must throw that water and keep our surrounding very much clean and dry, because these mosquito breeds into the clean water which is stable. We must celebrate a weekly dry day. By these we can stop from breeding that mosquito. Okay. Next point is spread of disease by direct contact. Ringworm, scabies are diseases that affect the skin. Their germs are found on the skin. If someone else comes in contact with the skin of that person having diseases, or wear his clothes, then that person can get that skin diseases too. That is why it is better to avoid sharing clothes. Next point is epidemic of diseases. The epidemic means the spreading of disease very rapid into the community.
germs of disease like flu or conjunctivitis spread quickly through the air, so many people can get such diseases all at one time. If the water of a common source is contaminated by germs of disease like cholera, then there is a danger of all those who drink that water getting the disease off at some place. Mosquitoes breed in a large number than many people, there can get malaria. When many people in the area get same disease at the same time, we can say that there is an epidemic of disease. So the spreading of diseases through air, water, food, insects, these are the medium of spreading diseases. So everyone must take care or ensure that the germs do not enter in our food, water, air, and to prevent the breeding of that insect, it must be possible through keeping a very much clean surrounding. If these infectious diseases spread through a medium, so there are also, we have some ways to prevent these diseases that the medium of spreading are cleaned and avoid to create such medium around us. We must keep our surrounding very much clean, and we ensure that the water, contaminated water, contaminated food stuff must not be get to near our houses or persons, house members. Okay, so to prevent diseases from spreading through water, it is purified at the waterworks. In a smaller town and villages, bleaching powder is added to community sources of water to kill germs. Make the water safe for drinking when there is an epidemic of gastro or jaundice. People are advised to boil water before drinking it. So, to prevent the water diseases, we must boil our water and clean it, and after that only we can drink. Okay? To prevent mosquitoes from breeding, we must ensure that there is no stagnant water in the surroundings. If that is not possible, insecticide have to be used. Thus, diseases like malaria can be prevented. People who have a serious infectious disease like tuberculosis, swine flu, are quarantined. There are separate wards in a hospital for people with infectious diseases. Clothes and utensils used by patients are washed with germicide. The spittle of a person who has TB is collected in a vessels and covered with germicides like phenyl. Such precautions help to prevent diseases from spreading to other. To prevent the spread of diseases through air, people should cover the mouth when sneezing, coughing, and avoid spitting in open space. It is necessary to be such a patient. A mask should be worn to cover the nose and mouth. So we must cover our mouth while sneezing and coughing. And if someone already get diseases, he must take care of while coughing. He must put some handkerchief or a mask on his face. Okay. If someone in the family get an infectious disease, the government health department should be informed so that necessary step for prevent the spread of the disease can be taken. Next point is vaccinations. When there is an epidemic of disease, we must keep that persons away from our area, or we must keep that persons in quarantine. Nowadays we have an experience the pandemic of the corona disease, that is COVID-19. It spread through coughing and sneezing. So every person must wear a mask while he comes into the outside or in the community. We must keep safe distance from other persons. Today we are taking care or with very serious to keep ourselves away from that corona diseases. Okay. And the government, on the other hand, the government try very hard for the innovation of the vaccine on COVID-19. Okay. So the vaccination is also one of the most important way to stop the diseases, such spreading diseases. Okay. Now look at this point. When disease producing microorganisms enter our body resist the disease or fight with the germs. That is why many times we do not get disease even if germs enter into our body. Another way to prevent disease is vaccination. In our body, we develop the resistance to a particular disease due to vaccination. Soon after a baby is born, she is given the TB vaccine. When the baby is 1.5 months, she is given vaccinations against diphtheria, whooping cough, tetanus, and polio. 2 more doses of the vaccinations are given at the intervals of 1 month. The vaccines for diphtheria, whooping cough, and the tetanus are combined into the triple vaccine and given is an injection. As an injection, the polio vaccine is given orally. So the vaccination is the major way to prevent the epidemic diseases or spreading diseases. So every child must get vaccines. Next point is public health and service facility. To prevent a spreading infectious disease, we must get vaccinated and we must keep our surroundings very clean. To prevent a spread of infectious disease and epidemics, health and community welfare programs are undertaken at national level. Community programs for vaccinations are also undertaken as a part of national health scheme. Children are given the vaccines by training people. Special camps are arranged for this purpose. Primary health centers have been established at the village level. There are also facilities like mobile dispensaries, ambulance and welfare fund for the disabled. Services like examinations of urine and blood, x-ray, ultrasound and other scan are also available through the health programs. Thus, patients can get the services they need without delay. People are also educated about the right method of handling drinking water and food. They are upgraded to maintain cleanliness in their surroundings. It is now forbidden by the law of spite in the public spaces. The purpose of this ban is to prevent the spread of diseases. Mass media are also used for raising public awareness. At the one time, it is believed that the diseases are caused due to the anger of gods, evil spirit, and due to black magic. The remedies prescribed for these were inhuman. However, science has shown that the diseases are caused by microorganisms, and these beliefs are false. Microorganisms are kind of living things. All microorganisms do not cause diseases. Some microorganisms are useful to us. They bring about conversion of the milk into yogurt and the fermentations of batter for the idlis and dosas extra. So children, here we complete this lesson thoroughly. You must read these lessons and get exercise of these lessons. Complete that exercise and send me a photograph of these questions at today evening. Okay, thank you.